Just got your Xiaomi 14T Pro, or maybe you've had it for a while and want to unlock the full potential. In this video, I'm breaking down all the tips you must know to make your phone faster, your photos sharper, and your battery life longer. Let's get into it, but first, hi, I'm Captain Awesome, this is Geekception, and I really appreciate if you hit that like button and subscribe as it really helps me out here on the channel. Okay, first, let's talk specs. This phone packs a MediaTek Dimensity 9300 Plus processor, the triple Leica camera system, 120-watt wireless charging, and many more which we're going to get into, but first, let's unbox it. In the box, we've got the SIM ejector tool, USB A to USB C cable that supports fast charging, and a gray matte TPU case, which is nice to have included here. Finally, we've got the phone itself with the phone specifications on the front wrapping. Okay, first impressions, and the first thing on holding it, and I noticed just how nice and solid it feels in the hand. I have the blue version here, which is a nice chill color. And just like its older brother, the 14 and the 14 Ultra, the 14T Pro here feels at home with the camera system co-engineered with Leica. But I have to be honest that I'm a bit disappointed that Xiaomi did not put the charger in the box, especially because they were one of the last few manufacturers that still did this. Okay, let's take a quick tour around the phone. And on the front, we've got a large high refresh rate display with a front-facing camera. On the right side, we've got the volume buttons and the power button. On the left side, there is nothing there. And of course, the back features the camera systems co-engineered with Leica, which I'll be honest, I'm very excited to test photo samples sometime later in this video. Okay, here's what you need to know to get the best out of your 14T Pro or even 14T with my setup guide, starting first with the display settings, which we're going to enable the high refresh rate here. And to do this, first go into your settings, select display and brightness, scroll down and tap on refresh rate. Then change the refresh rate from the default, which is automatic adjustment, to custom. And here you can set it up to 144Hz, which is the highest screen refresh rate offered on the Xiaomi 14T Pro, which I think you've paid the money for it. You should absolutely be enjoying it. Next, let's change the color scheme. And here, the original one called the Original Color Pro is the default profile. I'm going to leave that selected as it is. And then I'm going to go to enable adaptive color. So basically, this changes the display according to the light around me, which is similar to something you get on an iPhone, for example, with True Tone. Next, moving on to security. And I want you to go into the settings, scroll down and tap on fingerprints, face data, and screen unlock. Then tap on fingerprint unlock. Choose your preferred lock method, pin or pattern. Here I'm going to use a pin. Then after that, you can set up your in-display fingerprint scanner. And after the setup is complete, your phone is secure. Next, let's switch from on-screen buttons to gestures. Go into settings and select home screen. Then scroll down and tap on system navigation. Then switch from button to gestures. And this allows you to be able to navigate with swipe gestures instead of the on-screen buttons, which I find to be much more modern and cleaner. Next, let's speed up the home animations to make the phone feel faster. Go back to the home screen settings, find animation speed, then change the settings to fast. And this will speed up transitions and make the phone feel just a little bit more faster. The last setting in the home screen settings I want to change here is to enable app drawer. Now currently all the apps are on the home screen, which in my opinion is way too messy. So let's change that. Go back to home screen settings, tap on home screen, then change it from classic to with app drawer. And while we are here, you also want to disable place new apps on home screen, which will come in handy later. Now if we go back to the home screen, we can just see how much more cleaner this feels here. And now that we've enabled the app drawer, I can actually see that there's tons of pre-installed bloatware apps here that I'm never going to use, such as Agoda or booking.com. Like, what? So I'm going to go ahead and uninstall all these apps, and I suggest you do the same thing too. Okay, battery. Let's save your battery health. First, go into settings, then battery, then tap on battery protection. Then select limited charging, and this will limit your maximum charge to 80%. And sure, this means lesser charge overall, but in the long term, this will definitely save your battery health. And while the Xiaomi 14T Pro supports up to 120-watt wired charging, which is just ridiculous, I suggest you actually charge it at a much lower speed again to save your battery life. Here's how. Go back to battery settings, tap on charging options, and change the wire charging mode from top speed to standard. Now the last battery setting here is definitely not where you expect. From the main settings page, tap on more connectivity options, then printing, then tap on system printing service, and then disable it. Also disable Xiaomi Home as well. Now of course, if you use wireless printing, you should not be disabling it, but for most people like me or even you, we will never use wireless printing from our phone, and this is just a way to save that battery life. Maybe negligible, but maybe that's all you need on a day where you are almost, you know, out. So yes, disable it, and that is the wrap up for battery settings. Okay, next, let's download more RAM onto our phone, and okay, maybe not as dramatic, but let's increase our extended RAM. Go into your settings and then scroll down and tap on additional settings. Go into memory extension and under special features, select 12 gigs of RAM. This will prompt you to reboot the device. So tap on reboot to enable the extended RAM and your phone will reboot. And just like that, we have extended RAM. Okay, lastly, let's make this device yours, which is kind of important because, you know, this is your phone. Okay, go into the settings and at the top, select about phone. Tap on device name and change the name to something you want. And in my case, we're going to make this my awesome 14T Pro. Okay, next, here are some of the first apps I always install in my devices. And I hope maybe you can find some apps here as well. And on opening the Google Play Store, the first app I'm going to search for and download is Bitwarden. This is my password manager of choice. And you know, you should definitely should be using a password manager. Bitwarden is free, is secure, is open source, and I highly recommend it. Next is Kiwi Browser. And I really like this browser because it enables me to be able to use Chrome extensions on Android. If you have very niche Chrome extensions or you just want to be able to use some of the extensions from your desktop on your Android phone, Kiwi Browser is for you. We know Xiaomi doesn't have the best reputation when it comes to ads in the interface, and this is where NextDNS comes in, which allows for system-wide ad blocking and just tracking in general, even if you don't want to block ads. I highly recommend you install it. And finally, I'll be installing Notion, which is my productivity app of choice. This is what I use to run my YouTube channel and practically just have everything structured and for maximum productivity, install Notion. Okay, next, my favorite part of this video, which is the camera tips and just setting up the camera to get the best quality out of the 14T Pro. And on opening up the camera here for the first time, I see a request to allow notifications, which I'm going to click allow while using the app. And a pop-up also asks me which style I prefer, whether it's a fresh and a vibrant like Leica style or natural and realistic. And I'm going to tell you, I am a huge sucker for, you know, that, you know, vibrantness. So I'm going to choose the Leica vibrant profile. And on opening the camera interface, there's a prompt to swipe down, and swiping down shows more available options here. And I see in the camera mode here, there are several focal lengths, such as, you know, the 0.6 ultra wide, the 1x camera, the 2x, which I think is a digital crop, 2.6x and 5x. And of course, you've got all the camera filters here, which I really like on this Xiaomi devices. Now, whenever I get a new phone, of course, my favorite place to go is into the settings. So let's head into the settings here. And under video decoder, I recommend you select H.265 for more compressed video so that you can shoot the same amount of video, but with much lesser file sizes. I also want to turn off auto frame rates to prevent reducing the frame rate in low light, which can have like this weird effect. And I want to go into preserve setting options to keep the previously used mode and enable for camera mode here. And in the main settings page, I want to enable notify about orientation so you don't take photos in the wrong orientation. It will tell you. And going back into the main camera interface and switching into portrait mode here, there's a pop-up for the two different portrait styles here, which is master portrait or Leica portrait. I always choose master portrait, and here you get several focal length options along with the master lens system from Leica, which I absolutely love. And switching into video mode, there's a prompt here for master cinema and what it does. Up top, I always make sure that I disable HDR as I don't like HDR recording on my phone. And the 14T Pro records several high quality video modes, in fact, up to 8K 30 frames per second on the main camera. And if you select 4K 60 frames per second, it's available on all the back cameras. But something to note here is that if you turn on master cinema mode, you can only shoot up to 4K 24 frames per second. And also the front camera maxes out at 4K 30 frames per second as well. All right, setup is officially done. Now, here are some of my first impressions about the Xiaomi 14T Pro. And first up, I'll say I definitely like the texture of the power button here. And I know it's very strange and out there, but it feels very powerful. I also like the design of this phone and the fact that the sides and the back of the phone are matte. I have very, you know, specific sensitivity to textures. And I love that this does not, you know, pick up fingerprints, and it just feels very nice in the hand to hold. And of course, the most important feature here for the Xiaomi 14T Pro is the Leica camera system. And as you can see on screen right now, I am, you know, showing some of the photos I've taken with this phone. And yes, this is easily hands down what I'm most excited for when it comes to the Xiaomi 14T Pro. And as I mentioned, you know, earlier in this video that I'm a little bit disappointed at the fact that Xiaomi now removed their, you know, charging brick. And yeah, they used to be like one of the last few manufacturers that still had a charging brick, and now RIP charging brick. And this is even more sadder when you consider that this phone has up to 120 watt wire charging and you can really charge this very fast, and it's not included in the box. All right, that's it. I'm done. That's my unboxing and setup guide for this Xiaomi 14T Pro. If some tips help you here, do you have any tips of your own? Please leave all of those things down in the comment section down there below. And you know, while you're still there, I would really appreciate if you hit a like, if you subscribe, you know, if you left a super thanks, if you, you know, went to my Patreon and bought me a coffee, if you really, really like what I'm doing here, because again, these videos take time, but I also really, really enjoy making them. And I hope you enjoy watching them as well. Well, I have been your captain of awesome. This is Geekception. And until the next time I shall catch you, don't forget to stay awesome. Text me when you get home so I know you got home safe. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. All right, thank you for making it to the end of the video. And yeah, for this video, I think I shot it quite a while ago and I'm just getting to editing it now. And so finally, I'm so happy because there's like so much stuff. Like I think I already said on my last video, which is the Galaxy S24 FE, this is it now that I've unboxed. That video is in the pipeline already. In fact, tonight I'm going to shoot some comparisons with this S24 FE and the Xiaomi 14T Pro, which is I think right here, which I use. So I'm going to go shoot the comparison tonight. But yeah, again, I really appreciate you making it here. This is for my special people, for my people who, you know, like watching everything to the end and just love connecting here. And yeah, last week was very busy. I released like 3 full YouTube videos, which I have not done in a while. And it's very different because I released it and I don't feel like the world is ending, which is a very different feeling because it's, you know, it's been a long time since I've been able to have a feeling like that. And today is Tuesday and hopefully I'm able to like publish this video today, and that would be the first video of my week. So it's nice that I am sort of on this treadmill now, and I just love the progress I'm making when it just comes to like doing all the stuff that I want to do, because there's just a lot of work to do. But how is your life? How is things going on with you? I always also want to know that as well. And as usual, put hashtag end awesome. So let's switch it up this week. So I know that you made it all the way to the end of the video, and just give me an update on how you're doing as well, and I shall be definitely looking forward to that. But yes, until the next one, I love you so much. I really appreciate you making it all the way here, and please make sure you take care of yourself. Okay, bye.